It's homecoming here on the campus of the University of St. Francis. Cougar football trying to cap off the weekend festivities with a victory if it can get one. After a week off, third-ranked St. Francis today hosts Lindenwood-Belleville, coached by Dale Carlson. And up on the wing to the right side is Kelsaw, as it will be first and goal. Motion by Kelsaw, the counter run, and there is Aaron Harris into the end zone with the first score of the day. 1 yard run by Aaron Harris. That is his sixth touching, a check at his fifth touchdown of the season. And that'll make it 6-0 USF here at the 8:40 mark.
Well, again, you talked to Joe, you called it just exactly correctly. They went heavy right behind Alex Woods, number 75, and Keegan Bruner, number 76 on the right side.
So here they come, improving field position, approaching midfield now. First and 10 for the Lynx. They're down 7-0, play action fake. And here is now the rush is on, and they've got the Boone for a sack. Back inside the 40 at the 39. They were coming en masse. Take your pick. Carson Harnish, one of them.
That's exactly right. Joining him in the backfield was Eric Dutton, number 39. So a great job getting some pursuit through the middle. The pocket collapsed way too fast for the quarterback to do anything with, and he had to eat that one.
Dutton had 9 tackles and an interception against Taylor. Crossed the 40, in fact. One runner. Here is the deep handoff, and now here, and they've got, I believe that's Griffin again, Jaleel Griffin, and he is swallowed up for another loss. Maybe gets a positive credit back to the line of scrimmage, but that is it.
Lucas Sparks, number 54, in there making that initial hit. A very surprising play call there, Joe. If the defense is coming because they sniffed the sack on the last play, you know they're coming again.
As well against Taylor, 7 punt returns, had a long of 39. He averaged over 17 yards a punt return. He waits at the Cougar 30-yard line.
They're going after this ball.
Chapman, high snap. Rush is coming and blocked. Gaston got a piece of it. Picks up the ball at the 30 to the 20-yard line. And if he goes into the end zone, but I think he stepped out of bounds. Cougars will have it, though, at the 24 of the Lynx on the block punt by Charles Gaston.
There were 10 guys up the line, Joe. St. Francis was toe-to-toe. There was no split whatsoever, and they brought the heat, and they were successful. The speedster, Gaston, out of Bishop Lewis, making that tremendous job on the edge to get his hands on that ball and make a great recovery.
Yeah, it's one thing to block the punt. It's another thing to pick it up and run almost for a touchdown.
Yeah.
So the Cougars first and goal at the 7, trying to tack on and add to their 7-0 lead. Ferrer. Again, looking for motion. Gaston is in there, and they'll give the ball to him. Turns the corner, looking for the pylon, and he's into the end zone. Little touch pass again. It goes as a pass completion, and Gaston back after missing the first part of the season. And a 7-yard touchdown run to the left corner, and the Cougars extend their lead 13-0.
So difficult to defend, Joe. Just so incredibly difficult, and great timing on display by the Cougars as well. Again, to set this up, Ferrer in the shotgun. The ball comes back to him. At the same time, Gaston is in motion. So as soon as he touches the ball, he flicks it forward to Gaston. And then there's the speed. Jets on Gaston's feet, and he gets around the corner for a touchdown.
Trying to get something going now. They're at the USF 35-yard line. 2 wide to the right, 1 wide to the left. And Boone out of the shotgun formation. 2 protectors are in. Play action fake. Wants to throw, and he is nailed.
Oh.
Coming through the middle.
Good heavens. Is that Hemmelgarn?
I believe it is.
Yeah.
98, Eric Hemmelgarn, who had 6 tackles, 1.5 for loss, and nailed Boone that time with a loss back around the 43-yard line.
There was 6 guys right on the line of scrimmage. You knew one of them was coming through. Big Eric Hemmelgarn was the guy, and he had a free shot at the quarterback and took it.
Crowd on homecoming kind of quiet right now. And Ferrer, long count from the line of scrimmage, short drop, throws to the left. He's got the coat. Coat trying to make a move outside. First down, 40, 45, 50. Into Lynx territory. He's down the left sidelines, but he's out of bounds. Official's going to, let's see where they say. He stepped out of bounds, trying to keep his balance, tiptoeing down that left sideline all the way to the 30, to the 27-yard line, I think.
So Gaston, clearly not the only kid on the field with speed, Joe. He was able to just run his way out of coverage there and just fly down that field. He was an arm push away from a touchdown.
But it'll be 2nd down and 8. Boone again with 2 protectors. Sprints out to Griffin and got away from the blitz. Kimmelgarn trips him up. Got enough of him. reaching in with that big paw, and that'll be a loss back around the 45.
Second sack on the day for Hemmelgarn right there, caused by, again, Lucas Sparks, who shot the gap and forced the quarterback to the left side, and who is there to clean up but Hemmelgarn?
So a loss of, and they're going to reposition the halfback protector now as Boone drops to throw and steps up and looking at a hit from behind. Ball is free. Scramble for it. Still loose. USF picks it up. And they'll run right side inside the 30, 25, 20. Cutting back, tripped up. They'll bring it inside the 15 to the 13-yard line. And that was Lee Stewart who picked up that loose football.
Caused again by Lucas Sparks. Tremendous that time. So set this up again on defense. University of St. Francis had six guys on the line at the snap. The two inside linebackers go back into coverage. So the quarterback got confused then, Sparks then, to strip that ball. And of course, Lee Stewart was right there with a tremendous run back as well.
They'll have it at the 13-yard line. Right side, kind of a wing back position now as Ferrer. Blitz showing defensive right side by the Lynx. They back away, and Green takes the handoff. Got a block. Works a 40, 35, 30 in a foot race, and he will go to the house. Justin Green, one snap of the football, and he goes 45 yards for a Cougar touchdown to make it 20 to nothing.
Fantastic job up front creating that seam, and of course the downfield blocking was there as well. And Green just put the rockets on and flew down that field so fast. Six more points on the board for your Cougars.
Justin Green to the house. Boy, he just glides, doesn't he?
He does, yeah.
Just kind of runs away from people. Doesn't look like he's moving that fast, but you just see the separation. Had a yard there, 9:22 remaining in the half. Boone out of the pistol, looks to hand the ball off. Here's Griffin, bounces outside, being scoured. Got him for a loss, back inside the 20, around the 17. You're not going to beat Spencer Coward.
No, you're not. He's got to try, though, Joe. But he just didn't beat him at all. Coward with that great pursuit angle and tremendous speed on the field that time. That's a great tackle for loss for the USF Cougars.
Belleville and Darian Boone out of the shotgun, drops two steps, wants to throw to the right, and picked off. USF gets it back. There's Coward at the 50-45, and looking for running room down inside the 40 he goes, and USF just like that gets it back.
Coward's upset with himself. He wanted a pick six. He surely did, but couldn't get it out there at the 40-yard line. What a whale of a game number 30 is having Spencer Coward for the St. Francis Cougars. Eyes down the field. He was following the quarterback, saw him release the ball, broke on it, and he was right there for the catch.
Third down and long. Ferrer needs a play right now, trying to reach the 29. Short drop. Looking, blitz is coming. And is picked up. He'll throws the left, and that one is tipped and grabbed. Kelsaw's got it inside the 25 and stepped out of bounds at the 22. Little bit of a tip ball, but Akeem Kelsaw kept the sharp-eyed focus.
Fantastic job by Kelsaw. Ball tipped by number 27, Arvid Tech, as he followed him across the field on the crossing route that time. And Akeem Kelsaw, the standout from Snyder, with great poise, keeps his eye on the prize, grabs it out of the air, turns it up the field, gets down to the 22.
Clock approaching 6 minutes, time remaining first half. Ferrer on second down and 8. Looks to his right side. He's got two wide out there. Looks that way. Throws the home run ball. He's got a man, and there's a catch made. Monte McDowell. Did he get a foot in bounds?
Touchdown.
20 yards on the touchdown toss. And I tell you what, Ferrer got all that he needed into that throw.
That was a thing of beauty on the far side of the field. McDowell had the step, beat coverage, and again, Ferrer puts the ball on the money. McDowell makes it look easy, so does Ferrer. It took a lot of work to put that play together, but it looked flawless.
And Boone, ready to take the snap again. Coward threatens the blitz. He's coming. They'll hand the ball to Griffin. And Griffin lost the ball, and USF, I think there's about two or three uniforms there. No indication yet that Harnish was trying to battle for it, and St. Francis does have the ball.
I think that's John Doherty, number 57, gets on that ball along with Harnish. And that is another turnover for Lindenwood. That's their third on the day.
As Ferrer under center once again. And looks to hand the ball off. This time a counter run straight up the middle. And they get into the end zone for a 2-yard touchdown run.
Yeah, that's going to be a flag too. I think this one's going to go against Lindenwood. There was a little frustration being taken out on the field between the linemen that time, as one of the linemen for St. Francis was thrown down after the play.
So 2 yard touchdown run at the 3:46 mark.
I don't know if that's the official call at this point, but we saw it plain as day up here in the box.
Les Anderson and his crew gathered around him. They have been buzzing around Darian Boone all first half. Shotgun formation again, wants to throw. Boone looks, steps up, and is grabbed. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that is it. Ryan Gegner at center, starting again at second half. Zach Medardo, Jalen Gamble, Keegan Bruner, and Alex Woods are the tackles. Screen again, comes Nicodemus, got a screen. 30, 25 on his feet, dragging tacklers. He is not going down all the way till the 10-yard line. This little guy is a tough customer.
I love it too much. The standout locally here, Nicodemus, out of Cherubusco, really showing us how it's done. Proud to wear the silver and blue down there for St. Francis, because he is just so low to the ground, so hard to bring down, and he never stops those legs churning.
Tough guy. And Kelso up on the wing to the right side. Here's a misdirection call, and they throw the ball. Crossing pattern. There's Nicodemus. Touchdown.
Wow.
9 yards, so he had the big gain that got him down inside the 10, and they come right back to him. Little drag pattern, 9-yard touchdown toss. Ferrer, his third touchdown pass of the ball game. That'll make it 41-0 here at the 11:50 mark.
Perfect execution, and again, hats off to Coat, because he is the one responsible for clearing that zone out. So he goes into the end zone and sells the hitch.
Coach Donley begins filtering in some of the twos and threes. Play action fake. Here's Ferrer, look in the middle. Throws as long as he can. He's looking down for Rocky James. He's got him inside the 20 to the 15 and down to the 14-yard line. And you talk about threat. There's another one. Rocky James, true freshman, 6'2".
Unbelievable. Standard cover two defense right there. Even with safety help, the corner right in step with James. Ferrer puts it on the money right over the shoulder. James brings it in and gets some good yards after the catch.
There's the running back, or is it going to be Harris? We'll check that in a moment. Here's the give now to Boswell. Boswell sweeping the left side inside the 10 to the 5 and reached out for the pylon. Touchdown.
There it is.
12-yard touchdown on the little sweep left side by Sean Boswell.
Jet sweep, again, being effective today, except for once when Gaston coughed off the ball here on the other side of the field. But Boswell showing some tremendous speed, good situational awareness. Reaches that ball for the pylon and was successful. He sniffed that end zone and he got to it.
Short yardage call, third down and short, third and two on a sweep coming up to the left side, but they're not going to get it that time. As Pearson Harnish, he had three teammates with him. Everybody came through and nothing there for the Lynx as they lose yardage and they will punt the ball away yet again today.
Yeah, this is a standard sweep. You got two lead blockers in front of you as you come across on the jet. The handoff of Pearson Harnish way too fast with a great pursuit angle. Gets his claws into the running back and does not let go.
Edward Mayo was the ball carrier. Tonight is 5. Boswell at the Cougar 48 in punt return. Here's the snap. Kick is away. Kind of a low end-over-end kick. Boswell's got it at his own 44. Works to his left midfield. 45, 40. And spun around and dropped inside the 40-yard line. So Jean Boswell again with a good punt return and excellent field position for the Cougars. And the question now with 7:30 still in the third quarter, how long will they stay with Ferrer and try to maybe look at Coker and Cenarius, others at the QB? I think Coach D still has nightmares about that Taylor game last year.
Right.
Here's a quick screen coming. They got Coat. Coat at the 35, 30, and a foot race. Trying to step out of a tackle, and he's gone to the house. Seth Coat with a touchdown now. 40 yards, one play, one snap, and one touchdown.
Just picture perfect. Great blocking out there to release Coat to the inside, and he catches that ball in stride, and they can't catch him. That's all there is to it. He had an opportunity to grab a shoestring, and they can't get Seth Coat.
Time of the score, 7:23. Play Cenarius in now, the third quarterback for Coach Donley. Empty backfield, throws to the near side. He's got a catch at the 36. And they'll have a first down out across the 40 to the 43-yard line. So the Cougars come with a short scoring, a control passing game. Will Chrisman on the receiving end.
Yeah, Will Chrisman out of DeKalb High School. 6'6", 207-pound freshman.
Lindenwood now, Belleville on this third down snap. As here's the drop by Cenarius. Looks to throw right side. He's got a man out there, and the catch is made for the first down at the 45, maybe the 44-yard line.
Duke Blackwell, love that name. Duke Blackwell, the wide receiver, 5'10", 180 freshman out of New Pal.
That's a football name.
Yes, it is. Blackwell coming up with a huge stretch, brings it in, and moves the chains.
Clock still showing 12 and a half minutes time remaining. A lot of shifting in the secondary by Lindenwood-Belleville now as Cenarius barks out the signals, looks left, now throws to his right, and in a seam, he's got a catch. That's Rocky James again, lost the helmet of one of the Lynx players, but the catch is made for a first down at the 33.
Well, again, another generous spot that time. He was right at the stick, and it looks like they're going to mark it a yard past. So James gets the first down. Hey, good poise back there by the quarterback to roll out of pressure, get a little area, find the right target.
And too wide to the left for Cenarius out of the pistol. And he looks, play action fake, he spins. He looks, it throws over the middle, and he's got a catch inside the 10 to the 5 and trying to get to the pylon, waiting for it, and they're not going to give it to him. That was Duke Blackwell, who thought he maybe had a touchdown.
I thought he did, Joe. That's a, well, I wasn't down there. It's on the far side of the field, but the pylon was taken out. Give the kid the touchdown. Come on. But, boy, they mark it all the way back at the 3.
Wow. And Cenarius with one wide. That's Rocky James to the right. Looks to the right on the quick pass. And he's got it. They've got a hold. They've got a touchdown. That's Rocky James. He ran the quick slant from right to left. So a 6-yard touchdown pass to make it 62-7.
And what a throw that was. Cenarius really throwing a frozen rope right into the ground. And James had to dig to get it. And he was very successful at doing so. A very well-executed little slant that time on the right side.
So Cenarius gets his first Cougar touchdown, throwing touchdown. First and 10 for the Lynx. A little motion by Ramsell as here's a pull down, and boy, they've got the new quarterback in there. And he is a drop. That's Chris Hennington, who we mentioned, redshirt freshman. And a little indecision, and that cost him a sack and about 6-yard loss.
Yeah, that's exactly right. Malachi Mannion, number 32, came in from his DN position out of Dearborn Heights, Michigan, and planted that quarterback.